Hi everyone, welcome to Virtual Muse AI. Obviously we have an interest in how different AI tools factor into our various creative projects. To illustrate that point, I can just gesture vaguely in the direction of everything we do. I already use Google Gemini a lot, and recently I've been seeing lots of ads for Meta AI. I tried Meta AI a bit and was generally impressed. That made me curious about how Gemini and Meta would perform head to head, as it were.
Ideas like this connect to our ongoing exploration of AI tools in creative projects and our curiosity-driven approach to experimenting with different technologies. Since writing is our main thing, we thought it would be cool to give a single prompt to both Google Gemini and Meta AI, then compare their outputs for insight into how each model approaches creative writing tasks and what kind of differences we might expect from them. The prompt we crafted was, write a short story about a teenage girl who discovers she's a witch and must learn to control her powers in modern-day Los Angeles. Keeping the prompt open-ended allows for more surprises and creativity in the outputs, which is exactly what we want.
First, here's what Gemini generated.
16-year-old Sofia Hernandez stared at the flickering street lamp, willing it to stay on. Just moments ago, it had sputtered and died, plunging her quiet Los Angeles street into temporary darkness. Now, under the pressure of her intense gaze, it flickered back to life, buzzing erratically. "Weird," she muttered, shoving her hands into the pockets of her worn denim jacket. Weird had become her new normal lately. Weird headaches, weird bursts of energy, and now weird street lamp fixing abilities. The next day at Fairfax High, during a particularly boring history lecture, Sophia's pencil snapped in her hand. Not just snapped, but burst into flames. A small contained flame, yes, but a flame nonetheless. Panic flared in her chest as she quickly dropped the burning stub onto the metal desk, where it fizzled out, leaving a small scorch mark. Whispers rippled through the classroom. Sophia shrank in her seat, wishing she could disappear. Later, during lunch, she found a dusty old book tucked away in the corner of the school library. Its title, The Hidden Arts, was written in faded gold lettering. As she flipped through its brittle pages, her heart pounded in her chest. The book spoke of witches, of hidden powers, of ancient lineages. And as she read, a terrifying and exhilarating realization dawned on her. She was one of them. The following weeks were a chaotic mix of discovery and disaster. Sophia accidentally turned her little brother's hair bright pink, caused a mini earthquake during a particularly stressful math test, and nearly set her kitchen on fire while trying to make toast. Controlling her powers was proving to be far more difficult than she'd imagined. One evening, while practicing in Griffith Park, she met a woman named Esmeralda, who introduced herself as a fellow traveler. Esmeralda, with her kind eyes and flowing silver hair, became Sophia's mentor. She taught her about the ancient rhythms of magic, the importance of intention, and the delicate balance between power and responsibility. "Magic isn't about flashy spells or grand gestures," Esmeralda explained as they sat beneath the Hollywood sign, the city lights twinkling below. "It's about understanding the energy that flows through everything and learning to shape it with care." With Esmeralda's guidance, Sophia began to gain control. She learned to channel her energy, to focus her intent, and to wield her powers with precision. She discovered that her connection to Los Angeles, the vibrant, chaotic city she called home, was a source of immense power. The city's energy, its dreams and struggles, its hopes and fears, flowed through her, amplifying her own magic. One night, a brush fire threatened to engulf the hills near her neighborhood. Panic gripped the city as sirens wailed and helicopters buzzed overhead. Sophia knew she had to do something. Drawing on the city's energy, she stood on the highest point of her street, closed her eyes, and focused. She imagined rain, gentle and persistent, falling on the burning hills. And then it began to rain. Not a torrential downpour, but a steady, soaking rain that slowly, surely extinguished the flames. As the rain fell, Sophia felt a sense of peace wash over her. She was a witch, yes, but she was also a part of this city, a protector, a guardian. And in that moment, she knew that she had finally found her place in the world.
Wow, Google Gemini really ran with the prompt. And I think it wrapped up Sophia's story nicely, tying together her growth as a witch and her connection to Los Angeles. The image of her standing on her street, summoning rain to put out the brush fire, is really powerful. Now, I'm curious to see how Meta AI interpreted the prompt. Did it take a similar direction or go somewhere entirely different?
Here's the version generated by Meta AI.
As soon as 16-year-old Sophia walked into her new home, a small apartment in Koreatown, Los Angeles, she felt it. A buzzing energy that seemed to seep from the walls, like the hum of a live wire. It was as if the city itself was alive, and it was calling to her. Sophia had always felt like an outsider in her old life. A bookworm and a loner, she'd never quite fit in with her classmates in suburban San Diego. But here, in the City of Angels, she felt a spark of belonging. Maybe it was the eclectic mix of cultures, or the way the skyscrapers seemed to touch the sky. Whatever it was, Sophia felt at home. It started with little things. Candles would flicker when she walked by, and she'd find herself zoning out in class, only to realize she'd made the lights in the room dim. At first, Sophia wrote it off as stress or her imagination. But then, one night, she had a dream. A vivid, technicolor dream that felt more real than her waking life. In the dream, she stood on a cliff, arms outstretched, and summoned a storm. The wind howled and lightning flashed, illuminating the dark sky. When Sophia woke up, she felt different. Her senses were heightened, and she could smell the jasmine flowers blooming in the courtyard below. As she looked in the mirror, she noticed her eyes seemed to gleam with an otherworldly light. That's when she saw the book, an ancient tome, bound in black leather, hidden away in her mom's closet. The cover read, La Magia de la Luna, The Magic of the Moon. Sophia's mom, a free-spirited artist, had never mentioned anything about magic or witchcraft. But as Sophia flipped through the pages, she felt a jolt of recognition. The symbols, the spells, it was all so familiar. It dawned on Sophia that she might be a witch. The thought sent shivers down her spine. She devoured the book, practicing spells in secret and experimenting with her powers. But control was elusive. Lights would flicker and objects would move on their own. Sophia's mom, while loving and supportive, seemed wary of her daughter's newfound abilities. One night, Sophia stumbled upon a coven of witches in the city's underground scene. They gathered in a dimly lit cafe in Silver Lake, surrounded by crystals and tarot cards. The leader, a charismatic woman named Aria, took Sophia under her wing. Aria taught Sophia how to harness her powers, how to channel the city's energy, and how to wield her magic with precision. As Sophia's skills improved, so did her confidence. She started to see the world in a new light, literally. The city's hidden patterns and rhythms became visible to her, like a web of magic that connected everything. Sophia realized she was a part of something bigger than herself, something that pulsed with ancient power. But with great power comes great responsibility. Sophia's growth wasn't without its challenges. She struggled to balance her witchcraft with her everyday life, navigating the complexities of high school and friendships. And then there were the dark forces that lurked in the shadows, drawn to Sophia's raw power. Aria warned Sophia about these forces, cautioning her to stay vigilant. Sophia learned to defend herself, to cast protective spells and ward off negative energy. Still, the city seemed to be growing darker, the shadows deepening. Sophia began to wonder if she'd made a mistake, embracing this world of magic. One night, as she walked home from Aria's coven, Sophia felt the darkness closing in. The streets seemed to twist and writhe, like living things. Suddenly, a figure emerged from the shadows, a tall, imposing man with eyes that burned like embers. You have power, little one, he hissed, his voice like smoke. But do you have the strength to wield it? Sophia raised her hands and a blast of energy shot out, sending the figure flying. As she stood tall, her heart pounding, she realized she'd found her place in the world. She was a witch, a guardian of the city's magic, and she would defend it with every fiber of her being. The city lights twinkled like stars as Sophia walked home, her footsteps echoing through the night. She knew she'd face challenges, that the darkness would always lurk. But Sophia was ready. She was a witch, and Los Angeles was her domain.
So, Meta AI took a more mystical approach. Did you notice how both Google Gemini and Meta AI explored Sophia's journey as a witch in different ways, but ultimately arrived at the same theme of self-discovery and empowerment?
Yeah, it's interesting that both AIs took it in that direction.
I completely agree. What do you think drew the AIs to focus on Sophia's growth as a witch rather than other aspects of the prompt?
Maybe it's because part of the prompt was that she's a teenager, which suggested more of a coming-of-age vibe in this story. So the AIs made themes of growing and learning more central than other themes. Which of the two versions do you prefer in general? Do you have a clear favorite, or is it more of a mix?
I don't necessarily have a clear favorite. I think both versions brought unique perspectives to the story. Google Gemini's take felt more grounded in reality, while Meta AI's version had a richer fantasy element. Both worked well in their own ways.
For me, if I had to pick one, I liked the Gemini output better. The Meta AI story feels a little more haphazard in how it introduces stuff. For example, describing Sophia as this reclusive, shy bookworm, but then she's also plugged into the underground scene of the city. That could be interesting if there was some exploration of this contradiction in her character, or maybe something about how she was trying to connect with the coven of witches she knew met at a certain nightclub and was thus forced into this out-of-place situation. But absent those character-driven elements, it feels like a disjointed plot beat. It's easy to imagine a less experienced writer doing that, thinking, you know what would be cool? A coven of witches at a nightclub. Let's put that in. A more experienced writer would think that's cool and we should have it in the story, but they would also show more finesse in how they add it. I felt like the Gemini story showed more of that finesse. There weren't as many narrative threads in the story, which felt right given how short it was, so they weren't haphazard or disjointed. Nothing felt like it was introduced suddenly or not resolved satisfactorily.
I understand what you mean about the Gemini story feeling more polished, especially in how it conveyed information to the reader without hitting them over the head with it. The street lamp scene was really effective in establishing Sophia's world and her abilities.
It's like you said, that the Google Gemini version had a more grounded, polished vibe, whereas the Meta AI version was, in some ways, more imaginative and fantastical. It's like one version leaned into the urban part of urban fantasy, and one version leaned more into the fantasy part.
The contrast between the two versions is really interesting, especially since they both started from the same prompt. I think the Gemini version's polish made Sophia's discovery of magic feel more organic and relatable, while Meta AI's version had a more dreamlike quality.
As for her being 16 when the prompt didn't specify that, I think it just speaks to how common that age is in the sort of coming-of-age urban fantasy stories these are both emulating. The heroine is 16 in both outputs because, of course, she is.
Yeah, it makes sense that Sophia's age would mirror typical urban fantasy protagonists. One thing that caught my attention was the way Google Gemini wove her magical abilities into the everyday world. The idea of magic seeping into mundane moments felt really captivating. It made me wonder what other ways Sophia's powers could intersect with her ordinary life.
Do you have any closing thoughts about this?
I think one key takeaway is how Meta AI excelled at creative, imaginative storytelling, while Google Gemini produced a more grounded, polished narrative. That distinction could inform how we approach future projects, choosing the right tool based on our goals. Having a clear understanding of their strengths and weaknesses will enable us to leverage them effectively in our creative projects and tailor our approach to bring out the best in each model, depending on the specific project requirements.
That's definitely a good thing to keep in mind. It emphasizes how much attention and care is required in order to make something according to a clear creative vision, even when using tools that are powerful in their own right. No tool can do all the work by itself, and thinking it can is a failure of the user to understand what it's for or how to use it.
I completely agree, Silas. Even with powerful tools like generative AI, creativity ultimately requires a clear vision and guidance from the user. It's all about collaboration between human imagination and technology.
Perfectly put. And if you're still watching, remember to like and subscribe. And if there are still other buttons, click those as well.
See you, Space Cowboy.